Discussion on universal definition of myocardial infarction. Though ECG is the first test for a person with suspected myocardial infarction, the stress has shifted to cardiac biomarkers with publication of universal definition of myocardial infarction. First universal definition of myocardial infarction was published in 2007. Fourth universal definition of myocardial infarction has been published in 2018. Please subscribe to this channel for future updates. Click on the subscribe button. Press the bell icon after that for all updates. Universal definition of myocardial infarction was under the joint auspices of European Society of Cardiology, American College of Cardiology Foundation, American Heart Association, and World Heart Federation. Myocardial infarction was classified into types 1 to 5, of which type 4 has subtypes A and B. Fourth universal definition of myocardial infarction has been published in 2018 by the joint ESC, ACC, AHA, WHF task force. There are types 1 to 5 with a subclassification of type 4 into A, B and C. Pathologically, myocardial infarction is defined as myocardial cell death as a result of prolonged ischemia. Myocardial injury is defined as elevation of blood level of cardiac troponin above the 99th percentile upper reference limit. Clinical evidence of acute myocardial injury makes it myocardial infarction. Type 1 myocardial infarction is due to atherothrombotic obstruction of a coronary artery, usually precipitated by a plaque rupture or erosion. A rise and or fall of cardiac troponin values with at least one value above 99th percentile URL along with one or more of the following is needed for diagnosis. 1. Symptoms of myocardial ischemia. 2. New ischemic ECG changes. 3. Development of pathological Q waves. 4. Imaging evidence of new loss of viable myocardium or new regional wall motion abnormality consistent with ischemic pattern. 5. Identification of a coronary thrombus by angiography, including intracoronary imaging or by autopsy. Type 2 myocardial infarction is myocardial injury due to a supply-demand mismatch. Examples are a precipitous fall in hemoglobin due to acute gastrointestinal bleed or a sustained tachyarrhythmia with clinical manifestations of myocardial ischemia. Type 2 myocardial infarction is commoner in females and has a poorer prognosis than type 1 myocardial infarction due to the often associated comorbidities. There may be associated coronary atherosclerotic disease. In type 3 myocardial infarction, clinical and presumed ECG evidence of myocardial ischemia are present, but the person dies before biomarker evidence can be documented. In case a subsequent autopsy shows a fresh thrombotic occlusion of an infarct-related artery, it should be reclassified as type 1 myocardial infarction. Type 4A myocardial infarction is associated with percutaneous coronary intervention. Myocardial injury in this setting is defined as cardiac troponin values above 99th percentile URL in patients with normal baseline or a rise of cardiac troponin values more than 20% of the baseline value when it is above the 99th percentile URL but is stable or falling. Absolute value of cardiac troponin should be at least 5 times URL. The clinical and ECG criteria are the same as that of type 1 myocardial infarction. Angiographic criteria are a procedural flow limiting complication such as coronary dissection, occlusion of a major epicardial artery or a side branch, occlusion, thrombus, disruption of collateral flow or distal embolization. Type 4B myocardial infarction is one associated with coronary stent or scaffold thrombosis documented by angiography or autopsy. If it occurs within 24 hours, it is acute. From 24 hours to 30 days, it is considered subacute. Late if between 30 days and 1 year, very late if beyond 1 year of stent or scaffold implantation. Type 4C myocardial infarction is due to restenosis after coronary stenting or balloon angioplasty with elevated troponin similar to that of type 1 myocardial infarction, but angiographic demonstration of restenosis as the cause is needed. Type 5 myocardial infarction is associated with coronary artery bypass grafting. Cardiac troponin value more than 10 times the 99th percentile URL within 48 hours of CABG is taken as the cutoff value for the definition. In addition, at least one of the following must be present. 1. Development of new pathological Q waves. 2. Angiographic evidence of graft occlusion or a new native coronary artery occlusion. 3. Imaging evidence of new loss of viable myocardium or a new ischemic regional wall motion abnormality. Here are a couple of important journal references. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for future updates and click on the bell icon for all updates. Thank you.